simplest way to design your wall gallery is one by one. Simply select the image you wish to use and then drag it onto the wall. From here, a single click, and then size it to how you would like the image to appear. The size of the wall art is indicated here. If there is no size here, then simply click View and then toggle Visible Sizes, and this will turn the size off. If you would like to add more images to the wall, simply select the image and drag up onto the wall. You can position and use the guidelines at the top and then drag the image down so the vertical axis is the same in both. Additionally, if you have a specific size in mind, then click the pen icon, and from here you can change the size to how you would like it to be. Another drag and drop technique is if we add a third image, select the two images, use the hand icon and drag it onto the main photograph, and this will resize automatically the same height as the main image. This also works the same way if we just select one image to drag it in and then touch the side here, and you can see it will size it automatically. We can now select all and adjust and move everything onto the wall space. We can always change the size of the layout to suit each specific wall art. When we move a single piece of wall art, you will notice that the smart guides are trying to line everything up so it matches perfectly with the other images that are already on the wall. You can see, for example, that this image on the left is perfectly aligned, and the spacing between here and here and here is exactly the same. If we move this, you can see that the guides are telling me that if I leave it here, it's going to be perfect, whereas here it's going to be central to the main image, but the gap between here and here and these gaps will be different. To make sure they are the same, simply drag until the smart guide here tells you to stop. By using the drag option to size the default sizes, as well as putting in custom sizes, this gallery designer makes your life quick and simple to design stunning pieces of wall art. Another design technique is simply to use the available auto design. To auto design, simply select the images you wish to use and then drag the images up, and you can see that it is already creating the drop zones for me, and as soon as I let go of the mouse, they will populate with the images selected. Additionally, and the same way that Album Builder can, you can select the Layout tab at the top and be presented with different wall art options. You can then adjust each image within the crop. For example, this image on the left, we can zoom in here. Simply double click, select the image and use the spanner icon at the bottom, and simply zoom in, size to fit, and then go back, and you can see the same crop has been applied. Auto design is a great place to start, but you can amend any of the auto designs to suit anyone's style or home. Swapping and changing images in Gallery Designer is really easy, but it differs slightly from the Album Builder. To swap any of the images, simply click and drag to the new space within the wall. Notice that any cropping that we have done will need to be done again. If you click on the image and move it, you may see some unexpected behavior. This is because you are moving the image and not the canvas. To rectify this, simply click on the image, return the yellow box around the image, and then move the canvas by using the hand key here. To to zoom and tilt the images, you can do this using the keyboard shortcuts. To find the keyboard shortcuts, these are under the Help menu and Keyboard Shortcuts. For instance, to zoom in on the image, hit the Command key and then a number on your keyboard, 5 being 50%, 8 being 80%, and then 0 back to no percent. To tilt the image, hold the Shift key and then your greater or less than key. As you can see, we're tilting the image to the right. If you would like even more control within the image, simply double click on the image and click again, and you'll be presented with the logos at the bottom here. On the spanner icon, you can see we have the same tilt effect and zoom effect. You can also change the opacity should you desire. Many photographers like to offer composites or a collage printed on one single canvas, acrylic, or cut into a frame. This is easily done and resembles that in Album Builder. First, select the main image in which you wish to design with, and then size the print how you would like your final composite to be sized. For example, if you would like a 60 by 60, then type in 60 by 60. Next, choose the additional images which you would like to add to the composite. Note, this must be more than one additional image. And now you will see we have multiple images on the collage. To finalize your design, double click on the collage and you will see one whole drop zone, much like in Album Designer. So I can hold the Option and Shift key and drag the sides in to give myself a border. I can also increase the image space in between each image, and the spacing will be equidistant between each image. I can also add a keyline, just like in Album Builder. And we can also take and move our images around, just like in Album Builder. And if desired, change the orientation from landscape to vertical, as well as adjust each drop zone individually using version 10's patented drop zone technology. But there's also more. If we click the View tab and then go to the Layout option, you can see at the top we have a Composite tab. And it's here, much like in Album Builder, there are preloaded composites you can choose from. You can also download more from the Fundy website. I like this one here, so we'll double click and we'll adjust the size to fit. We'll put this at 60 by 60. Now that both the size and the composite has been created, we can also change the images within the composite as desired. In this designer overview, we have learned to create our own collections and composites, as well as use some of the automated features available in Gallery Designer as part of the Fundy Suite.